What is up, Trembler Nation? I'm your host, Killer Keemstar. Let's get right into the news! Bryce Hall is threatening to beat up Karina Kadif. We got that story for you. I got on the phone with Mr. Beast and he gave me exclusive footage of this Squid Game video. It is insane. That's a screenshot, but we got the whole video. We're gonna show you the video. Jake Paul, Logan Paul, boxing drama. And speaking about boxing, we got footage of Deji boxing. We found him. Yeah, Deji's been missing for 4 months. We found him. We got footage. And people were like, I don't think that's Deji because he looks thin. He looks slim. It's Deji. We confirmed it. Some lady weaseled her way into LA and scammed all the YouTubers. Wait till you hear this story. The creator of YouTube is going after YouTube. And Steve Will Do It got harassed by a homeless man. We got all these stories for you today, but buckle in because this episode of Drumler has been sponsored by 3Chi. 3Chi has the purest Delta 8 THC products on the market. You have to be 21 or older to buy, so stop it, kids. They're the OGs and the best in the industry. My favorite product is the HHC Pineapple Express, being my absolute fave. They got vapes, edibles, oils. They got it all at 3Chi.com. The link is in the description. Make sure you use code KEEM to get a 10% discount. Code KEEM. And for our first story, last week, YouTube announced that they're getting rid of the dislike count, all right? It just says dislike. You can't see how many people are disliking the videos. And we told you on November 10th, YouTube uploaded this video explaining why. Well, Jawed, which is the creator of YouTube, you might recognize this video. It's called Me at the Zoo. It is the very first YouTube video ever uploaded by the creator of YouTube before they sold it to Google, named Jawed. He left a comment on YouTube's video saying, Matt doesn't look excited because he knows it's the wrong decision. And you know that Me at the Zoo video, the very first video ever uploaded to YouTube, he changed the description and it now reads, whenever a YouTuber agrees that removing dislikes is a stupid idea, it probably is. Try again, YouTube. Okay, listen, all right? This thing happened the other day on Twitter, all right? It was trending. Surviving Sophia was trending on Twitter. What was this about? Well, a bunch of influencers got into Twitter spaces. Look at all these people with stories about this woman, Sophia, that scammed them. Yeah, so this starts trending. This woman, like, weaseled her way into all these social circles with influencers and scammed the hell out of them. Like, dude, this is insane, okay? So then Mike, Big Mike, realizes that he was one of the first victims. Listen to this. Roll it.
One girl was there who wouldn't leave us alone.
Oh my God.
Do we want to talk about that,
girl?
Yeah,
we should.
This.
We had a girl last night that I met at the event. She came up to me and she was like, oh, I work with Triller. And I'm so happy that I found you guys because I needed a friend to hang out with tonight.
Yeah.
And now you're my friend. And you're my friend now. And she proceeded to find her way into every single setting throughout the course of the rest of the night and was removed forcibly by security at every single event.
Yep.
And would look at me and go, why is this happening? I showed them my identification. And I'm like, that gets you on airplanes. It doesn't get you into parties with celebrities and boxing champions. Like, she just kept coming back. Dog.
No, bro. Jake, I've never said. Everywhere
time
I looked,
after time,
this girl was there.
She was here at your house.
She somehow got into your house, dude. Wait.
Was this the same one that got kicked out?
Yes.
So the same girl?
GP, let me explain this. She was in the suite.
Yes.
At first, I went up to her because she was very sweet.
I love her persistence.
She was very nice. And I said,
it was impressive.
I said, I'm so sorry to do this to you because I know you like having friends at the event that you're working on. She was like, that's totally no problem. I didn't mean to encroach on your... So I'm so sorry. Then she showed up at the nightclub. Mm. Guys, what's up? I'm back. I'm like, are you serious? I go, security comes in. They go, she with you. They look up at me and I go, get her out. They dragged her out. I come here for the after. It's 4:30 a.m. I walk in. Chick's going in the bathroom, like, yo, what's good? I'm like, dog.
Wait, she was here?
Yes.
She came here?
Yes. House.
No way.
I go, okay.
That's the origin story. From the Jake Paul versus Ben Askren fight until now, this woman, Sophia, has allegedly done all of this. Okay, so her main alleged lie is that her mom died and she needs $4,000 to pay for funeral expenses. First, she claimed that she was pregnant with Jack Harlow's baby. Then she lied about knowing him. She lied about working for him. She stalked him. She claimed to be sued by Jack Harlow. And then she also claimed that Jack Harlow and Ricky Thompson allegedly R'd her. And also claimed she was R'd by Harlow's security. Okay, so get this. She uses these Jack Harlow stories to then meet Ricky Thompson, who she scams him out of money, then uses Jack Harlow and Ricky Thompson to go scam Jeff Wittick for undisclosed amounts of money, claiming all this is true, then use Jeff to scam Dixie D'Amelio, Olivia Bryan, Denzel Dion, Future, Drake. They're alleging that this woman has scammed influencers for like $11 million. And this just scratches the surface, all right? Like this, a whole documentary needs to be done on this. This is insane. And speaking about insane, Bryce Hall, a bunch of mess with him. As you may or may not know, Bryce Hall and Karina Kniff have been beefing. They've been battling. Well, Bryce Hall threatened to kick Karina's butt. Seriously. It even came out on the Tana's podcast. Watch this.
I called out Karina for a boxing match. People took it seriously. I don't understand how people like people are actually dumb.
You want to clarify that on my podcast?
Yeah.
Called anyway.
Yes. Clip this right now. I did not call Karina out to box because obviously I'd whoop that ass.
He's like, apparently Dream is the simp for Karina Kniff because he recently tweeted at Bryce Hall that he would kick Bryce's butt. I would love to see that fight. And speaking about fights, there is a fight coming up between Jake Paul versus Tommy Fury. I'm super excited about this. I'm actually going there to watch this live because this is going to be the biggest test that Jake Paul has ever received. And you know what? Tommy Fury's father recently came out and had some words for Jake Paul and Logan Paul.
Round after round, I say not. He's not been used to it. He's not been bred to do it. And you can spar and do as much as you want in the gym with the 18-ounce gloves and headgear on. With the small gloves on, you get a man who knows how to fire shots randomly at you. You know, and Tommy, if he's on his game, Tommy, and he's firing all four cylinders, easy night to work, easy money. Mm. And the winner goes on to bigger and better things. We'll get the brother out of the game as well. And then we'll start looking at conventional titles.
So you mean you think he'll fight Logan as well?
Well, the brother's going to want to redeem his other brother, isn't he? The brothers, when he knocks Jake Paul out, the brother's going to want to take his part, isn't he? But I don't think so, because they're hiding. Tommy's going to get Jake Paul. The other brother won't be interested either. You know.
Is that a fight you'd want for Tommy after Jake Paul?
I would, yeah, because there's plenty of money there.
Yeah.
Okay. But speaking about Logan Paul, you guys all know that Logan Paul fought Mayweather. Now, Mayweather was saying he didn't even try. That's right. Michael Benson was reporting that Floyd Mayweather said, "All I did was work out from time to time. If it was a real fight, it would have been a blowout first round." Whoa. Logan Paul exposed by the Mayweather. All right. Listen, Mr. Beast is coming out with this big video. It's called Squid Games. He's redoing the whole thing. Everyone is looking forward to this. I got on the phone with Mr. Beast and said, "Listen, I help drama alert out. All right. Give us a sneak peek," and he did. Check this out. The tug of war scene, this man, Mr. Beast, has spent like $5 million on this video. I can't wait to see it. I think it comes out on Monday. Also in the news, Steve Will Do It has been stalked by a homeless man. Listen to this, roll it.
It's the craziest. He comes to the Bible with all these sticky notes. He says, "Steve, you're gonna perish tomorrow. You're gonna die." And
a random guy he's a homeless
guy. He's trying to save me. He needs some of my time, and I wasn't having it because I didn't believe him. But then for a few days, whenever I walked out of my building, he would follow me everywhere and saying he's not going to eat any food, he's not drinking any water, the Lord's talking to him, I'm a prophet, and he's trying to save me.
I hate that.
But he followed me everywhere.
This was like next level weird.
But it was next level weird. But it was like literally I went and then I didn't believe him. Then I went to the gym. No, but he just followed me everywhere. Like, I'd be in a restaurant, and then he'd come in, and he'd be sobbing. Like he wants to save me.
How many times?
This went on for, like, 4 days where he followed me everywhere.
It's time for a restraining order! And now for our final story. One YouTuber has went missing. We are talking about Deji. He's been gone for 4 months. Where is he? What is he doing? We had leaks that he was getting ready for another boxing match, that he was getting in shape. And yesterday, leaked footage of allegedly Deji boxing came out. But nobody could verify. Here's the footage. Ladies and gentlemen, I triple confirm what you just witnessed was actually Deji in the gym. But ladies and gentlemen, that is it for the news today. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, take the time to slap a like on it. Tell a friend to go subscribe to Drumler. Keep those notifications on because you don't want to miss a thing. Drumler Nation, now over 5,700,000 subscribers.